हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम सम रूट टू लीफ नंबर. ओके, सो व्हाट विल बी गिवन इन दिस क्वेश्चन. यू आर गिवन द रूट ऑफ अ बाइनरी ट्री दैट कंटेन द डिजिट्स फ्रॉम 0 to 9. ओके, ईच रूट टू लीफ इज अ पाथ इन द ट्री रिप्रेजेंट अ नंबर. सो व्हाट वी नीड टू डू इज वी नीड टू सम ऑल रूट टू लीफ नंबर. ओके, सो इफ यू सी दिस एग्जाम्पल, सो 1 इज द रूट and 2 and 3 are its left and right children. So if you start from 1 and move towards 2, so we will get one number that is 12. Okay, similarly if you start from 1 and move towards 3, you will get a number 13. So what you need to do, you need to add both of them and return the value as 25. Similarly, if you are going to see the next example, here we have 495 491 and 40. Okay, so here I will show, make the diagram and show it to you. So we have numbers like this: 4 9 5, here we have 0, here we have 1. So first of all, we are going to traverse in this situation, okay, like this. So the number will become 495. Then we need to traverse like this, then number will become 491. Then we need to traverse here, so it will become 40. Then we need to add all of them. So what we are going to get? 1026. So this we have to return in the solution. Okay, I hope the question is clear to you. We are going to start from root and then we are going to go towards the leaf node. Perfect. Now let us see how we are going to do. So as you can see, we have first number as 495. Now how we can get 495? We can write like this: 4 into 100 plus 9 into 10 plus 5. Yes, we can write like this. Now try to think how we can get the number. Okay, so one thing is clear, that we want multiples of 10, correct? This is clear. So what we will be doing, we are sure that we have to start from the 4, because we are starting from the head or node, main node. Okay, so we have to start from the 4. So as you can see here, there are 3 numbers. So we got like this: 4 into 100, second number is 9, so 9 into 10, and here it's, we can say 10 to the power 0, it is 10 to the power 1, and it is 10 to the power 2. Okay, so this thing how we can get. So if first number is 4, so what I am going to do, I am going to write like this. Let's say my current sum, okay, current sum will be equals to current sum into 10 plus node dot value, and initially current sum value will be 0. Okay, so we started from here. Now current sum value is 0, because till now we haven't traveled anything. So current sum is 0. So how we are going to get? 0 into 10 will be 0, plus what is the node dot value? That is 4. So current sum has become 4 now. Then we came to the second element. So what is the current sum? 4. Now we need to multiply it with 10, and the value is 9. So it will be 49. So our current value will become 49. Now we came to the third element. So what is the current sum? 49. So 49 into 10 plus value is 5, so it will become 495. So our value will be 495. Okay, so this is the thing that we want, and that we have got by this piece of code. Current sum is equal to current sum into 10 plus node dot value. Okay, now we have got current sum, right? Now we also want to find this. Okay, 491. So we can't update the same value. So what we are going to do, we are going to make one more value variable, self.result. And as soon as we are going to reach on the leaf, what we are going to do? We are going to add that value to current sum. Okay, means initially the value sum is, result is 0. After reaching this, what we will do? We will add 495. Okay, then we will again traverse like this, and then we will add 491. Okay, then again this will end, then we will add 40. So like this we are going to do, and we are going to get our solution 1026. So basically what we have to do, as soon as we reach at the leaf, we have to write this command, self dot result plus equals to current sum. Okay, so I hope the approach is clear to you. So we are going to start from the main root node and we are going to come on the leaf. So we are going to use DFS approach to go from top to bottom. Okay, so like this we are going to solve the problem. So let's say our question is sum, okay, in which we are going to get only node. Okay, so initially self dot root is equal to self dot result is equal to 0. Okay, then what we are going to do, we are going to recursively call the for each and every node. So what we are going to do, we are going to write one more function and that function will be DFS, because we are going to traverse from top to bottom. So we are going to use DFS approach. So root, and initially we are going to pass that result as 0, and then we will be returning our result, that is self dot result. Okay, now we need to write this DFS function. Okay, so let us write the DFS function, define DFS. Okay, which will have two values. What are the two values? Node and current sum. So initially current sum value is 0, that's why we passed it at 0, and root value is node. Now what we are doing, so first of all we are in recursive solution, we will be writing terminating condition. Suppose if there is no node, so if not node, suppose we are in the situation only 5 is there and there is no node. Okay, so what we will doing, we will return it, we are directly going to return. Else what we will be doing, I told you that suppose if we have elements like this 4 5 and 2, so we need to make 4 5 2. So what is the logic for this? Logic is current sum equals to current sum into 10 plus node dot value, correct? So we have got this value, right? Now as we have got the value, now we need to check. So here there is no left node and there is no right node. So if there is no left node and there is no right node, so what we will be doing, we will be updating our result. Okay, so we will write the condition like this: if not node dot left and not node dot right. Okay, if both are not there, it means we have reached the end point, means we have reached this 2. So what we will doing, self dot result plus equals to current value. We are going to update the current value into current sum into self dot result, and then what we will be doing, we will finally return it. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Now so we started from here 5 4 2. Suppose there so what we have done, we have gone through the left hand side and then we have to go to the right hand side. Suppose there are elements like the 10 and 13, so we have to go on the left hand side and we have to go on the right hand side. So what we are going, what we will be doing, we will calling the function self.dfs, and what we will be doing, we are going to call for node.left, and we are going to pass current sum, as well as we will be calling the function for right hand side, that is node dot right, and we will be passing the current sum. Perfect. And this is the code that will solve our problem. So what we have done, first of all we have checked if there is any node or not. If there are no node, okay, directly return the solution. Then we try to find the current sum. Okay, this 542 542. Okay, now we are checking if there is no left node, if there is no right node, then update the result and return the solution. And we will be doing this for left node, and we will be doing this for the right node. So this is the code that is working absolutely fine. And if you want to see the working solution of the code, so I will show you the results. I have already tested this code. This code is working absolutely fine. Okay, so you can check it out. I will paste the comment, I will in the comment section I will paste the code for this. Okay, so thank you.